guys know me. I was also a big fan of this show called The Spectacular Spider-Man Animated Series. One of the best Spider-Man animated cartoon shows ever made. Spidey fan, you will not want to miss this. If y'all want to read the bio, if anything, but one of the coolest about the show, it's just so good that it focused about Spider-Man, his friends, and learning more about, I guess you can say, the origins of the villains. Like in the very first episode, we would have survival. Spider-Man will be fighting against Adrian Toomes, aka the Vulture. And then episode 2. Well, let me actually show this one back. Episode 2, fighting against Max Dillon, known as the Electro. And then Dr. Connors against the Lizard in episode 3. And the first one I'm surprised. It came with this cover. I like it because it makes it look $5 just because I love the show so much I had to buy it. When I first even heard about the Shocker, I was like, who's that guy? He looks weird. Why does he dress up like for some reason it reminds me like oven mitts, you know, like those type of designs they would do with oven mitts. I don't know, like I never understood who this guy was at first, so until years later I learned the story and origin of the Shocker. The Spectacular Spider-Man is truly spectacular, of course. Market forces, competition, and now we would have the Invisible Hand, Spider-Man fighting against three villains, Shocker, Sandman, and Rhino. They're all pretty good episodes, but I like the Market Forces because I like Shocker's powers. As you can see here, like he's throwing a shock blast, a shock wave. Man, the show was so good. I like the design of the villains. Spectacular Spider-Man. Contains episodes 4 and 5 and 6 from the hit TV series. Yeah, this show was, I just fell in love with it. Because the music of it, it's just episode Volume 3. We would have Spider-Man fighting against Green Goblin, one of his arch nemesis, arch enemy of Spider-Man. And then Dr. Otto Octavius fighting Dr. Octopus. Very interesting. I feel like in this episode we will learn more in depth about the Green Goblin and his actual plans. Same with towards the end, which we'll get there in a bit. But now this we're like, no way. In this episode, I remember at the end of episode 6, that's when Spider-Man encounters the big man of crime, L. Thompson Lincoln. It's kind of, it looks like a, I don't know, but like a zombie or something. I always get that vibe from him. Reactions to Dr. Octopus and the Green Goblin. I always like his design, the Green Goblin. It's like a Halloween suit. But pretty cool character, so I like it. Contains episode 7, 8, and 9 from the TV series. Good stuff, good stuff. Spider-Man engaging with Venom. Yeah, we got Venom back there. I like his design a lot. Pretty cool. And we can all see in the mirror back here from a black suited Spider-Man. It's just like in Spider-Man 3. Like a mirror between the red and blue suit and the black suit Spider-Man. This one contains 4 episodes, which is pretty cool. Spectacular Spider-Man is pretty much that. That's where he fights against the Sinister Six and group therapy. Pretty cool. And we also are introduced to Black Cat. Who hardly appears like in. Who hardly appears much. Like our last appearance will be, first appearance and last will be in Persona, but towards like. Episodes, whatever episodes, I think Volume 7, I believe that's where like she last comes in. I don't know, it's just kind of weird. Like, she just randomly appeared. Like, I even questioned myself, like, whatever happened to her. And then we have a group shot of Sandman and the tentacles of Dr. Octopus. That's where like the Sinister Six happened, and then intervention, and then. That's where Spider-Man or Peter Parker fights with the symbiote, with his mind, until he rejects him, and then the symbiote finds a new host, which leads to this for like the last episode of season one. Nature vs. Nurture. Spider-Man Peter Parker must fight against Venom. This one's pretty cool because we get like the black and the red, blue and suit Spider-Man. You can see like how big his spider symbol is bigger compared to his regular suit. I don't know, this suit was always one of the best ones. Shocker with Kraven and Mysterio. Sheer strengths, I think that's where like they take down their headquarters of the villains. Something like that. That's just my personal opinion. Kraven the Hunter, we still need to see him in the big screen, but who knows when though. After that comes in this one, the return of Venom and Sandman. I feel like this is some true shot, or like a resemblance of Spider-Man 3, Venom and Sandman. It would have been cool if Sandman and Venom did actually team up, like what they did in Spider-Man 3. Oh well, they could have done it better. What's this? We get three new episodes. However, in this episode, we are introduced to another villain. I guess you can call him a villain, but he goes by the name as Colonel Jupiter. Kind of a strange one, though. I don't know, it's just kind of weird how they call him Colonel Jupiter. Spider-Man, and he's right like next to a chandelier. Whether you're a kid or a fan of Spider-Man, this show seems to have something for everyone, and I kind of do agree. Oh, I forgot her name. She's the daughter of Silvermane, but I forgot her name. If anyone can remember what's her name, like, leave a comment down below. It's been a while not watching this show. But I still have it in mind, like how it goes and everything. But I just forgot her name, though. Pablo calls the return of Shocker. I wonder whatever happened to him, because we haven't seen him since the Sinister Six on Volume 4. Until he reappears again here. Kind of strange, though, but oh well. I guess that's how the story goes. Spider-Man fighting against Silver Mate, Dr. Octopus, and also the Big Man of Crime, aka L. Thompson Lincoln. I don't know, it's just kind of weird. It would have been great to see more, in my opinion. I think it would have been much more cooler if we would see more supervillains fighting each other. Not just Spider-Man, but I think it only happens in this season, in this volume. This episode, we would have like Hammerhead fighting against her and the Rhino, and here we would also have Dr. Octopus, Silvermane, and L. Thompson Lincoln, the Big Man, fighting each other. It would have been much more cool to see more villains fighting each other, but that's not point of the show. It's more about Spider-Man, obviously, but oh well. Sadly though, because we never got a season 3 of The Spectacular Spider-Man. Because I also remember watching a video about this show and how they were already introducing to new villains, because they already Easter egg some of them in these episodes, such as Cletus Cassidy, Carnage, Morris Bench, Hydro Man, and I think they made, I'm not too sure, but also like Matt Gargan, Scorpion, and I guess also the Hobgoblin or whatever. But yeah, I would love to see those villains in this show, but I know that's not gonna happen. Speaking of that, I also remember back then McDonald's was promoting the show, and I did add a few toys, Happy Meal toys from these. Like these right here. They're pretty old. I just remember I had them in a container. Spectacular Spider-Man Happy Meal toys. They're pretty old, obviously, and they're like from 2008. I forgot where it, oh, here it is. 2009, actually, but yeah, with this one, it came with like a little spider web, and then you just put it in there and just, you know, just spit out the spider web. There's like a little button here, but oh well. The spider symbol's already faded away. I also have this Dr. Octopus one, but I don't have the arms though. pretty weird. I used to be in love with this one a lot because you could, like, I remember in the arms, it had suction cups, and you could, like, stick it to your window or something, and that made it look so cool because it would actually crawl in the wall or something. But sadly, I don't have that. And it's kind of old. No, not really. It doesn't really look. I guess it could look kind of, but it could use a little bit more facial expressions. But yeah, I have this glider. It doesn't have a screw, so I could, like, take it out. I don't know what the heck happened to this one. I think my little brother took it out. It had, like, little screws on the glider, but you could also see the detail of this glider. It looks like a giant bat. I thought they were copying the Batman or something. Want to see how it looks without it. It looks pretty cool. I like the detail of it. Whoops. But yeah, these are gonna be displayed within the show, so it's pretty cool. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you guys did, smash that like button. If you're new to the channel, subscribe to my channel. And as always, have yourselves a good night. Until the next video.